right, so we're night one, and we're going right into our first winery of the entire Stars of Pinot Noir. And we've had the pleasure of talking with Guillaume Lange before. He's the winemaker at Renaissance and in Willamette Valley. But right now, he is in Burgundy with his family and, of course, working with the House of Louis Jadot, the ownership of the brand. Hello, Burgundy. Hello, Guillaume Lange. How are you?
Hello, Yann. Very good. Thank you. Happy to speak with you from France, from Burgundy, you know, where I was able to travel for the first time from 2019. But your accent is perfect, so it's not so far, you know. Voilà.
my heart is in Burgundy always. Well, I thank you so much for joining us, and we're excited because this 2018 wine remains one of our, not only our best sellers, but a wine that I'm really proud to start off the Stars of Pinot Noir with. Take us through the journey of Renaissance.
Good. I will just share the screen with you.
Great.
Voilà, so just a few words about Renaissance Vineyard, about Renaissance, the brand Renaissance, the project of the Maison Louis Jadot, as you mentioned, Yann, the first time that Maison Jadot is making wine outside of Burgundy, you know, so a great adventure. The story, you know, of this project, this is the Willamette Valley, this is the trip of Thibaut Gaget and Jacques Lardière, the head winemaker of Jadot in 2013, the brand. The label as well, very different from the style of the Maison Jadot, something new, a new terroir, the expression of the label of the terroir of Renaissance Vineyard. You can see this photo from this beautiful vineyard, planted at the beginning of the 80s with ungrafted Pinot Noir, but this is what you can see on the label, you know, the tree lines, voilà. Alors, bon, we are really located in the northern part of the Willamette Valley, in the area of the well-known AVAs of the Willamette Valley, sub-AVAs like Yarmil Carlton, Dendils, Chalet Mountain, Hirola Amiti, bon, voilà. So Renaissance Vineyard on the western side and Découverte Vineyard closer to Cascade. Inspiration, you know, the very proximity, you know, connection with the Coast Range. And this is where we are planting Pinot Noir and Chardonnay. From 2017, so a new terroir, voilà. And then the hills, so the Découverte Vineyard or vineyard planted from the 90s. That is the volcanic soil of the Willamette Valley, the Jory soil, red color, and give another expression of the Pinot Noir. And what is interesting, you know, this is the idea, of course, to express
this picture. I love this picture. Guillaume, because it's, you know, it's you, it's Jacques Lardier on the far right, or standing right next to you in that other picture. 40 years, he was the winemaker for Louis Jadot, just an amazing man. And Pierre-Henri Gaget in the yellow jacket, that he is the son of he's...
André Gaget, yeah.
André Gaget. So it's... I got to have dinner with him in his home in Burgundy in Beaune many years ago, and it was one of the great meals and experiences of my life because he went down and pulled up a 2014 Moussigny from the cellar that had never been touched.
Good.
Oh, I said 2014. I meant 1914.
Oui.
It was a magic bottle. It was still purple.
Great.
Crazy.
Great experience.
Yeah.
We can fill our barrels and we age our Pinot Noir and Chardonnay in the Cadus barrel, the cooperage of the Maison Louis Jadot as well to give enough time to reveal the expression of the terroir of the William. Voilà.
I forgot that Jadot owns Cadus. It's one of the top barrel manufacturers, barrel producers for Burgundy wines.
Right. Voilà what I can tell you about Renaissance today. is still new, still a new project. In fact, in the Willamette Valley, it's a little bit different from Burgundy. We have to plant, we have to produce, we have to make the wine to understand the expression of the.
So the name resonance play on the on sound waves, and you can see that in the label. I just think it's a brilliant name and a brilliant wine. We're in the Spectator Top 100 last year with this wine, and top 100 wines of the world, correct?
Yes, correct. We were honored by the Wine Spectator 2015. It was the first vintage, you know, Willamette Valley Pinot Noir 2015 was in the top 100. And last year with the Willamette Valley 2017, we were at the 19th rank. So we are, again, very proud and very honored by the Wine Spec. But voilà, the idea to have the expression of the Pinot Noir from the Willamette Valley with the blend of different location, different single vineyard, blended together. Voilà. So this is a part of the history of the Maison Louis Jadot as well. You know, to forge relationship.
But it's also
the geology.
It's the same latitude as Burgundy, right?
Exactly, almost the same latitude. So that gives more connection between the two wine regions more than we imagine. You know, and something very very easy to understand, for example, during the summer, during the growing season, if you check the daylight, so the number of hours of light during the day, this is exactly the same number of hours between the city of Beaune in Burgundy and the city of McMinnville in the heart of the Willamette. That means the conditions of growing are almost similar than in Burgundy for these particular thing, not everything.
You can sum it up in one word. Voila! There we are. We're in the Willamette Valley, and thank you, Guillaume. We're going to taste the wine now with Rachel, and we appreciate your time. Enjoy Burgundy, and we'll catch up with you soon, because this is a pretty exciting time up in Oregon. I think you timed your trip perfectly. It's 118 degrees or something like that up there this week. So I'm sure the grapevines will be happy to see you when you return.